evolution by natural selection is fundamental to understanding life. It is one of the big scientific ideas. It makes sense of why it's the case that animals have specialized body parts, why we have the origin of new species, why we have this amazing diversity on Earth. And most people are not in evolution by natural selection until high school or undergraduate years. But we also know from our research that if we start early and they haven't developed certain habits of mind, it's easier.
How can we show that it takes many generations for the population of homoceles to change?
In the Innovative Evolving Minds curriculum, first-hand investigation and storybooks guide students as they develop a model for the process of natural selection.
How is a population of radishes likely to change when hungry caterpillars arrive?
To build their model, students work with data in small groups and make sense of what they're learning in whole class discussions. They investigate populations of organisms by observing individuals closely and documenting variation. They measure and represent the distribution of trait variants. They follow the fate of a storybook population of Pelosis after it's subjected to a dramatic environmental change, then represent changes over time in the distribution of trait variants in the population as a result. Students see if their model can explain real cases.
How can we explain how anoles evolved bigger toe pads?
Having tested the model in these scenarios, students find that their model of natural selection can explain how any population could change over time. Next, students follow the fate of another population of Pelosis, where the environment changes dramatically and isolates a subpopulation of animals. They find that in this case, the model explains how a new species, the Murungas, come into being. Fossils provide evidence for speciation.
How do we know what plants and animals were like long, long ago? What can fossils tell us about the history of present-day organisms?
Third graders can understand the mechanisms of natural selection. Third grade teachers tell us that they appreciate the teacher guide and materials that support classroom enactment and student engagement. And their students' understanding can then lay the groundwork for learning evolution in middle and high school.